and we are going to move to the screen. All of you, for the first 10 minutes, I want you to look at the slide. Only for 10 minutes. It is very simple. Gender is very simple. For the first 10 minutes, I want you to look at the slides. Then we will move to the book. Okay? Yes. So now let me start. Here you go. So this is your English class, and as usual, I welcome you all. Yes. And the topic which we are going to learn today is gender. Always remember, based on nouns, we can learn lots of grammar topics. For example, when you learn noun, you can learn the kinds of nouns, that is common noun, proper noun, collective noun, possessive noun, abstract noun, material noun. So just by learning nouns, you can learn the kinds of nouns followed by it. Once you finish kinds of nouns, if you know nouns, with the help of nouns, we will be learning another topic, which is singular and plural, based on the nouns numbers. Okay, based on the nouns numbers, we will be learning singular and plural. If it is only one thing, it is a singular noun. If it is more than one thing, it will become a plural noun. Now, similarly, see the next topic which you can learn if you know nouns. The next topic which you can learn if you know nouns is gender. Now, what is a gender? How we divide gender? How we divide gender? Can you see the slide here? Nouns can be divided into male, female, neuter, and common. I'll repeat again. Nouns can be divided into male, female, neuter, and common. This division of nouns is called a gender division. Okay? So, when we divide the nouns into male, female, neuter, and common, we call it as gender division. Now, how many kinds of gender are there? As I told you in my previous slide, there are four kinds of gender. What are those? Masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, neuter gender. Can you all repeat with me? Start. Masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, neuter gender. Shall we do it again? Kinds of genders: masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, neuter gender. So there are four kinds of gender. Now, can you see this? Have a close look at it. Masculine gender refers to names of boys or men, that is male. Masculine gender refers to names of boys and men. Can you see the examples? Father, son, priest, uncle, rooster, horse, king, hero. Now all these names, the nouns, refer to gender, which is boys, men, or on whole we call it as male. Now coming to feminine. Now feminine gender refers to names of girls or women. Altogether, it represents females. Can you see the example? Aunt, mother, maiden, grandma, hen, goose, nun, niece. So all these nouns come under feminine gender. See the next, third gender, which is a common gender. Common gender refers to names of both girls and boys, both male and female. So these kinds of gender come under common gender. Now when I tell you the examples, you will understand better. Doctor. May it be a lady doctor or may it be a gen. We call them as doctor. So may it be a male or female, we can put doctor under common gender. See nurse. May it be a man or may it be a woman. You call a nurse as a nurse. Now see visitor. May a lady come to visit you or may a gentleman comes to visit you. On general, they are termed as visitor. Similarly, friend. Friend doesn't have any gender bias. Even if he is a girl, she is your friend. Even if he is a boy, he is your friend. A friend is a friend. So it comes under common gender. Similarly, cousin. May it be your sister or may it be your brother. All comes under cousin. Manager. Relative. Singer. So all these comes under common gender. Now, what are neuter gender? Okay. Masculine gender? Fine. Male. Feminine gender? Fine. Female. Common gender are the nouns which are used to refer both male and female. Now, what is a neuter gender? Neuter gender refers to names of things or objects. Can you see eraser? While seeing the eraser, can you tell whether it is a male or a female or a boy or a girl? No, isn't it? Now when you see a desk, can you say whether it is a male or a female? Or when you see shoes, purse, chocolate, book, car, pants, can you tell whether it is a male or a female? No, right? So such nouns comes under neuter gender. And normally neuter gender refers to things or objects. Do not worry. We will see about all this in furthermore detail. Now can you see? A noun that denotes a male is said to be the masculine gender. Can you read the examples? Boy, man, father, son, brother, husband, grandfather, uncle, nephew, king, prince, actor, waiter, policeman, wizard, emperor. All these nouns refers to a male. It denotes a male. So it is called as masculine gender. Now, can you see the images, children? Can you see these images? Yes. Now, all these people, they belong to the masculine gender. A horse belongs to the masculine gender. Bull belongs to masculine gender. Stag belongs to masculine gender. And lion, king of the jungle. So, he is also a male. Now, coming to feminine gender. A noun that denotes a female person or animal is said to be of the feminine gender. Now, shall we see the examples? Now, can you see here? A queen, a woman, girl, mother and daughter, grandmother. So all these people, the nouns comes under feminine gender. Now, common gender. Common gender refers to member of species that can be male or female. These can be either male or female, like teacher, child, worker, friends, cousins, neighbor, etc. Now, for your better understanding, can you see here the image on the screen? I told you, right? A friend is a friend. May it be a male or may it be a female. Now, parent. Parent is a common term used to refer either your mother or your father. Now, do you understand what is common gender? Now, teacher. May it be a sir or may it be a madam. A teacher is a teacher. Similarly, I gave you the example of a doctor. Did I not? So all these comes under common gender. Now I'm moving to neuter gender. I told you about neuter gender and I gave you one more hint saying that in neuter gender we always have things or objects. Can you see here? Can you see a calculator, apple, your graduation hat, your geometry box things, your globe, pencil, then you have something called this, what do you call? A zoom. You used to have this to zoom and see things, right? I forgot the name. Tell me, okay? If you got it. Now, can you see an apparatus, a paper, a sheet, ruler and a notebook and a pen, ball, marker, all these are non-living things. And while you see a non-living thing, you cannot determine its gender. You cannot say whether it is a male or it is a female. So those things, usually non-living things, they come under neuter gender. Can you see? A noun that denotes a lifeless thing is called neuter gender. A watch, house, pen, book, pencil, all these comes under neuter gender. Till this, are you all clear? Now let me come to the come here. Now let me ask, yes, magnifier, yes, thank you, magnifying glass, yes, a magnifier. So till now, are you all clear? I see a lot of yes from a lot of people. Janeshwar, Anu, okay, Balsairam says it's clear. Kavya, Ishanvi, Dhiran, Pradesh, Abhishek, Ajish, Digan, Devasena, Mitraksha, Harshavardhan, Tarun, very good. Vishnu, Selvasundar, Kavin, fine, good. Sadhana, okay. Digan, Lakshana, okay, okay. Dia, very good. Yes, I see lot of people here. So now I hope you understood. I hope you understood. Very good. Let me again share my screen. We will see what do we have next. So with this, the basic definition of gender, like, and the kinds of gender is over. Only four kinds of gender: masculine, feminine, common, and neuter. Yes. So now in today's class, before we finish this class, let us do an exercise. Let us do an exercise. Ready for the exercise, all of you? Yes. If you are ready, please take page number, take page number 28. We have got gender topic still, but before we move into the next, which we'll be seeing in the future classes, I thought let us finish one exercise at least from the book. Okay? So are you all ready? Ready? Is there anyone? Let me come to the queue. Is there anyone saying that, ma'am, I don't have my pencil? Ma'am, I don't have my book. No one, right? I instructed even before I started my class that I want you to have your language structure. Yes. Yes, Abhishek, I want you to be ready with your pencil. And the page number is 28. Page number is 28. Ready? Very good. So Dhiran says he has everything. Very good. Yes, after the class, I will send you the Google form. Huh? After this class, I will send you the Google form. Okay? So you can finish it. You can finish it before today evening. For Google form, I'm giving you time till today evening. And for assignment, I'm giving you time till Friday. Yes, those who don't have a book. Now coming to people who don't have a book, take your rough note or your English notebook if you have. Page number 28. Page number 28. Language structure book, Kavin. Language structure book. Where will you learn grammar? You will learn from your grammar language structure book, right? Yes, Ishanvi, I'm going to show you all that. Now all set? All set? Yes. So we are going to do the exercise. Now please see your book. Give the masculine gender of the following nouns. So feminine gender is given here. You have to do the following nouns, masculine gender, for the feminine nouns. Now first, you see which W-I-T-C-H, please repeat along me, along with me. W-I-T-C-H is which? Yes, now I will show you. Yeah. Can you see the masculine gender for which? I have given you along with the image, wizard. Wizard. If it is a man who knows magic and all those, we call him as a wizard. And if it is a woman who knows magic and all those things, we call her as a witch. If you have read the popular fairy tales like Cinderella, Snow White, you might have come across witches. So if it is a woman, we call her as a witch. If it is a man, we call him as a wizard. If you have seen Harry Potter, you may come across wizards. So W-I-Z-A-R-D, wizard, witch. Have you all written? Now you can fill the first blank. You can fill the first blank. You can look at the slide and you can write wizard. W-I-Z-A-R-D, wizard. I'm giving you enough time. Please don't tell me that, ma'am, I'm not getting time to write. Or don't tell me that, ma'am, I haven't written. Harshavardhan, are you writing it fast? Yes. Please write it without spelling mistake. W-I-Z-A-R-D, wizard. Very good. Now let us move to the next. See, nun. You have the feminine gender, nun. So Ishani was asking me as, ma'am, what is nun? Now, nun is a woman who has dedicated her life for the service of God. So those women are called as nun, who have dedicated their life for the service of God. Now can you see a man who has dedicated his life for the service of God and for the humankind? We call them as monk, M-O-N-K, monk. Please write it down. M-O-N-K, monk. So monk, nun. Monk, nun. Clear? Shall I move to the next slide? M-O-N-K, monk. Just four letters, children. Yes, I hope you have written it, and I hope you have written it neatly also. I want your presentation to be legible. Now, yes, Digant, are you writing? Please write. Yes, now see, niece, N-I-E-C-E, niece. What is the masculine gender of niece? It's nephew. Nephew, N-E-P-H-E-W, nephew. Mitraksha, are you writing? Nephew, N-E-P-H-E-W, nephew. Niece, nephew. So who is a niece and a nephew? Your brothers or your sisters. Son is called a nephew and daughter is called as niece. If you have an elder sister who has a son, then we call him as a nephew. And if your sister or brother, if they are having a daughter, then we call the daughter as your niece. So nephew, niece. N-E-P-H-E-W, nephew. Dipesh, are you writing? Nephew, N-E-P-H-E-W, nephew. Just a six-letter word. Write it neatly. Now let us come to the next. What is this? Filly and colts. Filly is the young one of a horse, baby horse. If she is a female, we call her as filly. If the baby horse is a male, we call him as colt. Filly, colt. Filly, colt. Four letter word, colt. C-O-L-T, colt. Very good. So I'm giving these four words today. The remaining words, you can write it. In my next class, I'm going to show you with the example once we complete this exercise, we can then again see few points to be noted while we are learning gender. Okay, there are few points to be noted while we are learning gender, which I will teach you in my next class. So it's already time up. With this, we finish off today's class. But yes.